Hi viewers, today most of them are fearing and having anxiety about the coronavirus, and it is really life threatening and people are really don't know what to do. And at present, at least so many countries, almost every other country is affected. In India today, as of now, at least 137 cases are reported. When it started in China, it started slow and then it became very high, and now it is spreading all over. So being an obstetrician and fertility specialist, I am more concerned about our own department patients who are pregnant when they have a mother and baby, and all the more high risk are there. And we have to know like whether it is spreadable or it is having any effect on the pregnancy and newborn. And so far only one study has reported saying that newborn is affected. But we don't know whether it has come from the mother or from the hospital staff or the place, because it's a droplet infection. We never know when so many people involved in the process of delivery and handling a newborn care. So we are not very sure whether it is passing through the placenta and the umbilical cord, or it is passing through the breast milk or amniotic fluid. So these are the three sources they are testing. Lot of testings are happening. So we have to find out when the mother is affected, whether the baby is getting transmitted or not. That is called vertical transmission or horizontal transmission from the surrounding people, and even mother, same mother can transmit the disease to the baby. So as of now, we don't have much data or papers. We may get in sooner, like after 1 month or 1 year, we may get clear cut idea about this viral infection. But as of now, we have to be protected. You have to take severe precautions because you are all immunocompromised. Your immunity level is very low. So you have to protect yourself. Don't go outside. Don't go to the crowded places. And don't go to the hospital. Even if there is a normal cold cough symptoms, please isolate yourself. Call up and find out. And reach out the correct isolation person or corona testing centers. And if you have a pain, anything related to obstetrics, pregnancy emergencies, if you have a pain, any leaking, any bleeding, don't hesitate. You have to call up your consultant and go to the proper hospital so that it can be managed. And the corona, it is not just like that spreading. It is only spreading through immunocompromised people who are traveling from abroad. And if they are not following hygiene methods and safety precautions, then only it is spreading. So don't get panic if you are having a labor pain or any pregnancy complication. Don't sit at home. Please call up your hospital or consultant and get an opinion from them and follow it up. Regarding the fertility patients and planning pregnancy, I would suggest as of now we can hold on for at least 1 or 2 months, because we don't know what will happen. What is the scenario after 1 month? We don't know. Now we are in March. We don't know in Indian scenario after 1 month how it will be. So we, at least whoever is normally planning, newly married couples who are planning a pregnancy, better to hold on for some more months so that at least safe pregnancy can happen. Another one, IVF. Regarding infertility treatment, even international societies are advising us not to plan any ART procedures. Even taking medicines to ovulation and plan a pregnancy, it should be avoided. So if it happens naturally, okay, we can manage. But if you are planning, you have a time, we can definitely 1 or 2 months we can postpone. And only there are situations where cancer patients, where fertility preservation is an emergency, very rare cases, we can definitely take the embryos and freeze it. Even in those patients who are going for IVF treatment, we can take out the eggs, embryo. If they are already on stimulation, we don't want to cancel or stop the treatment. We can definitely take out the oocytes and form an embryo, or oocytes can be frozen and kept. But embryo transfer, when we are placing the embryo back or planning the pregnancy, only is advised not to plan now. So my sincere advice is at least hold on for some more months, at least 2-3 months. Once we are very clear about that, and when we get the proper data, we will also will be able to tell you correctly whether it is affecting or not. If you are delivering again in a proper unit where all the safety precautions are taken and they have a facilities to manage, so those are the centers should handle this kind of deliveries and pregnancies. So take care and follow hygiene methods, and don't go out, stay inside. Only in emergency you reach out to the hospital. Thank you.